The scatter plot drawn above, we'll take a look at it after we finish reading the question, depicts the average annual United States per capita consumption of high fructose corn syrup between the years 1970 and 1985. Which of the following functions best describes the relationship shown? So when we look at the scatter plot, we see that it definitely looks like we could fit a parabola to it. We could find a curve of best fit. And that parabola might look something like this. Again, I'm just kind of estimating it, trying to draw a parabola with my hand. It's going to be a hand-drawn parabola, but it's going to look something like that. And what they're saying is, look, they've given us some candidates, some quadratic functions that would describe this curve of best fit or this parabola of best fit. And so which of these could it be? Well, there's a couple of things that you might immediately see. The first is that a couple of these choices have a positive coefficient on the highest degree term, on the second degree term. And then the other ones have a negative coefficient on the highest degree term. Well, if you have a positive coefficient on the highest degree term, on the second degree term, and if we're talking about a quadratic, you're going to have an upward opening parabola. And if you had a negative coefficient, it would be a downward opening parabola. And what we have here is clearly, it looks like the right half of an upward opening parabola. So we could rule out the ones that would be downward opening. So we could rule out the ones that have a negative coefficient on the second degree term. So let's rule those out right over here. And then when we look at the remaining two, we see there's a fairly dramatic difference in them. They have, you know, this is 201 versus 0.201. 264 versus 0.264, 969 versus 0.969. And so we could really look at our curve right over here and get a sense of and test some points. So if you look at, well, maybe the easiest one is to actually test when x is equal to 0. So when x is equal to 0, depending on how we draw our curve, our y is going to be pretty low. Our y is going to be close to 0. I'll just write close. Close is going to be close to 0. It's going to definitely be below 5. It's going to be probably definitely below 2. So let's see which of these choices describe that. So when x is 0 here, this term goes away, this term goes away, and we're left with 0.969. So y would be 0. So this has the point 0, 0.969 on it, which seems pretty close to our criteria that, hey, we want when x is 0, y is pretty close to 0. Let's see this one. This choice right over here, when x is 0, this term goes away, this term goes away, y is 969. So here, in order, if you picked this choice right over, this is not close to 0. This is nowhere, this actually would be off the charts right over here, the point 0.969. It wouldn't even fit on that graph. So you can definitely rule this one out, and we would be left with that choice right there. And you could try other points, but that one would definitely be the easiest to evaluate.